Bernie is on fire, and with just 11 days to go until Iowa and 19 days until New Hampshire, Bernie Sanders positioning himself now as the front runner in the polls. A new CNN national survey has him topping perennial leader Joe Biden for the very first time, as the other candidates seem to either be falling or just stagnating. And he's actually widening his lead now in New Hampshire, not to mention pretty much every big name in the party feuding with the socialists, Elizabeth Warren, Hillary Clinton, Joe Biden. They're all going after this guy. Joining me now to discuss, IWF senior policy analyst Inez Stepman. You know, it's amazing that after the heart attack, people wrote him off, you know, politely, but everyone wrote him off. And he seems to have gotten stronger, more convincing. He's picking up momentum. And then there was the hit on him being anti-women. And that even seems to be backfiring.
Yeah, it's backfiring because it so blatantly just doesn't land right on Bernie, right? Of all the things one could accuse him of, right, being an octogenarian socialist, being an octogenarian communist, but dishonesty, I mean, this is the guy who comes out and says he wants felons, right, in prison, murderers, to have the vote. He's not a guy who's super, super concerned about expressing his views. And then there's the matter that I think his policies and his views actually are the heart and soul of the Democratic Party, much more so than somebody like Joe Biden. And that's why I think you're seeing this race tighten up.
Inez, was that always the case, though? Or I think it's a natural evolution to this point. I think if you look at, for instance, what President Obama believed in, and if you just connect the dots, it was going to come to this. But it feels like this is a transition that the elites in the party are afraid of.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely think that, you know, we had all this conversation, right, about where the Republican Party was going when we had the shakeup with Trump, and then previously with the Tea Party, right? I think they're having the same thing in the Democratic Party. The party elites and the party establishment, they're afraid to go with somebody like Bernie, but you're seeing voters. You know, I think voters on both sides, if you look at polls, survey after survey after survey, you see the majority of Americans are not happy with the way that policy or politics has been conducted for the last 30 years on the right or on the left. They're not happy with the traditional Republican Party, and now they're not happy with the traditional Democratic Party. But you're right, they've moved so far to the left that Obama's policies, even Obama's VP, is running away from Obama's policies. I mean, that's a remarkable thing.
That's amazing. And by the way, it's not just a U.S. phenomenon. It's a global phenomenon.
Yeah,
whether
absolutely.
You go to, you know, Brazil, Japan, China, India, Brexit, Italy, almost anywhere in the world, Austria, I mean, anywhere in the world you go right now and there's a major pushback. We'll see it somehow in Spain where we can see a major, major revolution there as well. So what do the elites do? Because we're watching this time. It feels like last time they mistreated Bernie Sanders. The rules were stacked against him. The superdelegates were stacked against him. The world's watching this time. Do you think they will try desperately somehow, if he looks like he's got the momentum, to take it from him?
I absolutely think they're going to take their best shot, just like everybody took their best shot at Trump in the Republican primaries. And similarly, I don't think that it's going to work very well. I don't think that, for example, Hillary Clinton coming out and criticizing Bernie and then suggesting and then walking back that she wouldn't support him as the nominee. The party's voters are frustrated with the party establishment. It's almost a boon for Bernie. It's a positive for him to point to. Now, I think he actually needs to be stronger about it and point, if he wants to win, he's got to point to those endorsements and say, look, this is not what you want. Again, you don't want Hillary Clinton, you know, part two, vote for me.
Inez, thank you very much. Hope to see you again real soon.